doing today?
I think I'm doing okay.
Are you going to make it?
Yes, I am.
Good.
I'm doing
good.
Fine.
Well, you're looking great.
Well, thank you very much.
Looks like you are ready to give her away.
Yes, I am. I'm ready to accept a son.
Yeah, that's wonderful. Well, I'm very happy for you.
Well, thank you.
God bless you all.
Thank you. sight of God in the presence of these witnesses, to join together this man and this woman in holy matrimony, which is an honorable estate, instituted of God. It is therefore not to be entered into unadvisedly, but reverently, discreetly, and in the fear of God. Into this holy estate, these two persons come now to be joined. If anyone can show just cause that they may not lawfully be joined together, let them now speak, or else their act is forever. Hold their peace.
Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
The mother of God.
Ken, you may be seated. Thank you. Jamie, would you take your place beside the bride, please? If you then have freely and deliberately chosen each other as partners in this holy estate, and you know of no just cause why you should not be so united, in token thereof, will you please join both hands? Civil ceremony, you could have been married by a justice of the peace. But by bringing this ceremony into the house of God, you are making your vows before God Almighty. You are vowing to Him that from this day forward, you will work at this marriage, you will make this marriage work. You are telling God that you are promising for better or for worse, that you will live together and honor each other throughout the rest of your lives. And the most amazing thing of this is that as you make your vows to God, the truth of it is God is very interested in what you're telling Him. I don't want to disappoint you with it. The bottom line is God is not so interested in what you're wearing or all the flowers or the decorations here. But God is very interested in what you're telling Him that you're going to do with each other. And He is so interested in that, that when we make our vows to Him, and we tell Him what we're going to do and what we promise God we will do, God also promises to honor us in this relationship. The Bible tells us in Proverbs chapter 5 and verse 21, "For the ways of man are before the eyes of the Lord, and He pondereth all his goings." If we had a different translation, it would say that He considers well all of our goings. He's very concerned about what's taking place right here, right now, in this place. And in the context of this verse, when you actually look at what's being said here, this is being said in the context of marriage. Several verses just before that, up in verse 18, it says, "Let thy fountain be blessed, and rejoice with the wife of thy youth. Let her be as the loving hind and pleasant roe. Let her breasts satisfy thee at all times, and be thou ravished always with her love." And then you get to verse 21. "For the ways of man are before the eyes of the Lord, and He pondereth all his goings." So God is very concerned about the marriage relationship, that you two will cherish each other and make each other special for the rest of your lives. There's another passage found over here in chapter 21, in verse 21. The Bible says this, "He that followeth after righteousness and mercy findeth life, righteousness, and honor." So the truth of it is, when you desire to follow God and be right with Him, God Himself turns around and says you will find life, righteousness, honor. God desires to honor your relationship and your marriage, and He wants to bless it. The truth of it is, He wants it to make it a little bit of heaven on earth. That's truly what God wants for marriage to be. Aren't you glad that God is going to be involved in your marriage to help you day in, day out?
Do you take the leaders you have in mind to live together? together after God's ordinance, in the holiest and in admirable, do you vow to love her, cherish her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, in adversity and prosperity, in sorrow and in joy, as long as both shall live? Do you, Malia, take James to be thy wedded husband, to live together after God's ordinance, in the holiest state of matrimony? Do you vow to love him, cherish him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, in adversity and prosperity, in sorrow and in joy, as long as you both shall live?
Jamie, would you please repeat after me? I, Jamie, take thee, Malia, to be my wedded wife.
I, Jamie, take thee, Malia, to be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part.
In sickness and in health, to love and to cherish.
I will take you, Jamie, to be my wedded husband.
I will take you,
Jamie,
to be my wedded husband.
To have and hold this day forward.
To have and to hold this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part.
In sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part.
Seven. Please. Jamie, will you place your ring on Malia's ring finger of her left hand, please?
With this ring, I be wed.
The circle has long been a symbol of God, without beginning or end, and with no point of weakness. The circle is a reminder of the eternal quality of God and of unending strength. Thus, these rings serve to remind us of the relationship which Jamie and Malia have with God, as well as the relationship which they have with one another. The rings are symbols of covenant and should serve as reminders of our vows to be faithful in all our relationships. Let's pray. Father, as these two people begin their life together, we ask you, Father, to guide and direct, and to give them, Father, your wisdom for each and every day of their lives. Lord, you know already that both of these young people love you, and that they're attempting to serve you the best that they know how. And so, Father, we commit them to you now as they begin life together. Lord, life holds many, many surprises that we must trust you for day in and day out. And so thank you, Lord, for your presence in their life. Thank you, Lord, for the promises of your word. And thank you, Lord, again, that you love us, that you've made provision for each and every person to know you personally, such as both Malia and Jamie have done. And now, Father, their intention is to keep you in the very center of their lives. And so guide them, Father, in a very special way. Use them, Father, mightily for yourself and for your own glory. And Father, bless their marriage. In Jesus' name, amen. We're down to it. In accordance with your solemn promises, thus made to each other before God and these witnesses, I do now therefore, by virtue of the authority vested in me as a minister of the gospel and by the laws of this state, pronounce you husband and wife. Jamie, should I let him do it? You may now kiss your bride. What therefore God has joined together, let not man put asunder. Ladies and gentlemen, may I present to you Mr. and Mrs. James Hatfield. Thank you.
Yeah, there's a good reason for that. She was born in Hawaii, And there they give out unusual names. But she was named for a particular flower, this particular one here, plumeria. So that's always been her special flower. And in Hawaii, they always make leis and give them out, and that is what we would like to do right now for Jamie and Leah, give them leis made out of plumerias.
Everybody get real close, blow lots of bubbles.
Lots and lots of bubbles.
Careful opening the camera.
Where is he? Okay. You see him?
It started.
Ken. She wants you over here.
We put Daddy. Burger.
Ken.
Daddy.
Ken. Maria really wants you here. He's coming.
Okay.
Emily, back up.
All right. Bye. Love you.
I love you.
Thank you for everything. Bye, Daddy.
Bye. Love you.
See you later.
Okay.
All right. Ready, Daddy? Take your car. Stay over here, babe.
Grams wants to say goodbye to you.
Oh, okay.
Bye, Grams. Thanks for coming. Let's see if we can get back up to
Green Bay. Okay.
What?
What happened to your mom? Oh, I have
buddies. Did you give them one? They'll give them one.
Do you want Bubbles to take with you?
Bye.
Okay, everybody wave.
Oh,
yeah. Bye, Maria. Bye, Jamie. Bye.
Oh, no.
Sorry about the seat being
thank you guys again.
Bye.
Bye.